Well, the CRPF had gone for duty at one particular crossing in that district, and when we reached the spot, the militants had already taken position inside the masjid, and they started firing at the CRPF party from inside the masjid. The CRPF retaliated the fire very bravely. This boy who was martyred, his role was very significant. The retaliation was effective. While this retaliation and the firing by the militants was going on, a private person, he came in a car and he got into the melee. Unfortunately, when he was getting down, and I think we are still to reconstruct properly, but we assume that when he was trying to take the child out of the car, he was shot on the back by the militant bullet from the masjid. All of us have gone to the spot and seen the angle of fire. We are very clear technically that this is the bullet of the militant. And the militant killed the man. The child obviously was scared. He ran and he was rescued by a boy of the CRPF who was there close by, and he took care of him till the firing by the militants continued. The militants were forced to flee away. They went inside the masjid, they went back, and from the rear side they flew away. The retaliation by the CRPF was effective. We found blood stains. Inside the mosque, we find more than 60 MTs plus 2 magazines. So this shows that the militants had taken position well in time, and they were waiting in the masjid for the CRPF party to arrive. I find this use of the mosque for such activities highly reprehensible. I think we, as from all the forces, we have the highest respect for all religions. We do not ever enter into a religious place, knowing the sentiments of the citizens of the place. However, this use, and this is a repeated use, not for the first time they've done it, I think I would appeal to the masjid committees of this valley, as well as to the citizens, that at least we should secure our religious places, not allow them to be hijacked by militancy. It was a very unfortunate incident, because he managed to, the firing by the militants started, and obviously that road is a busy road, and he got caught in the firing by the militants, and he was killed by the bullet of the militants. It was an extremely unfortunate incident, which I think some people have tried to give it a spin by saying that the CRPF took him out of the vehicle and shot him. Yes, this is totally untrue. I would say with full responsibility, after visiting the place, after talking to everyone, after examining a lot of technical details, and including cameras. So we are very confident of what has happened. I would request the people who are spreading these carnage, they should blame the militant, that militants are hiding in mosques and trying to, in their great eagerness to kill security forces, they don't care about whether a child is there or an elderly person is there, they just fire. The man, I would say in unequal terms, the man, the unfortunate civilian who died, has been killed by the militants firing from a mosque. And there is no question of the CRPF being involved in this. In fact, the CRPF was restrained, knowing that the mosque, they are firing from the mosque. So even the firing by the CRPF was restrained so that we do not cause any damage to the mosque. See, all the security forces, whether it's the Jammu and Kashmir police, or the Indian Army, or the CRPF, or other paramilitary forces, we are all working in perfect synergy. And I'm sure if we are still waiting for details about the yatra, as and when the details come, we are all prepared. We'll be making all due arrangements, and we'll make sure that whatever form of yatra is held would be done peacefully.
Subscribe to our channel and push the bell icon to get video notifications on your smartphone.